Today I'm going to begin with the next part of your first unit, which is mentioned as methodology in your syllabus, and it includes field and laboratory studies. So today mainly we are going to focus on field studies, and field studies or geological field work is an integral and important part of your geological course. Any geological course needs to have field visits, because the textbook features or structures that you study in the classroom are not exactly same in the field. So to set your eyes on these geological features or to understand and interpret their importance, you need to visit the field regularly. Now I have jotted down few points, and I'll give you the reference and some of the important points. I'll elaborate in the description of this video. You can go through that. So you know that the field work is exciting, it is enjoyable, and at the same time it is challenging. So when you are planning to do a field visit, you need to follow certain protocol, and I have given some points here. The first thing is you need to have the tools of the trade with you. So tools of the trade means the equipments, the geological equipments. So what are the geological equipments, and what are the important geological equipments that I'll give you that you need to have with you before you visit the field? Otherwise it will go in vain. Next is the safety in the field. Now safety is important not only in geological reference, but if you are a petroleum geology student or you are a mining professional, in all fields, in all professions, safety is of utmost importance. So safety, I'll tell you, is one of the important or the most important factor in this study. The next thing is what to look for. So before you visit, you need to do some research work, and you should know what you are expecting in the field. If you don't know what you are going to look for, it will be difficult for you to make any logical conclusion at the end of the field visit. Next thing is field notes. Again, very important. When you go to the field, you need to have a field diary, and you should know how to note down your observations. And the last thing is graphical logs. You can make your litholog based on your observation of any section in the field, and when you come back to the classroom, you can go through the litholog, and you'll be able to imagine the section that you have seen. So what is the grain size variation, what are the structures, the thickness, the gray, all those things can be represented in a litholog. So one by one we are going to see these aspects. The important tools that you need to carry during the fieldwork are listed down here. You have to make sure that you're carrying, if not all, the important equipments with you during the fieldwork, starting with the field diary, which is required to note down your geological observations, and pen and pencil, appropriate clothing according to the climate and the surroundings, the rucksack or haversack to carry your samples, the collected samples. You cannot keep your samples in your plastic bag, or you cannot carry these samples in your own bag. Then clinometer compass. It is the most important equipment that you need in the field to find the strike direction, the dip direction, the orientation of the structures that you are going to see. and you should know how to use this clinometer compass. So you should know the theory of the clinometer compass, how to handle it, how to hold that clinometer compass before you reach the field. Then a hand lens is important because you can observe these samples with the help of lead, with the help of lens. You can make close inspection. The microscopic study can also be carried out in the field itself. One more important thing I forgot to tell you about the hammer is the size of the hammer and its shape or its dimensions should be appropriate to be carried in the field. And it is also important that you use the hammer sensibly and you should be sympathetic towards the outcrop which you are observing in the field. There are certain outcrops which are unique and not present everywhere, so in those cases it is better to avoid the use of hammer. In certain cases it is better to take a loose sample from the outcrop rather than breaking down the feature itself. So it is very important to use the hammer sensibly. And along with the hammer, it's better to have a chisel. You can use it to break down the hard and compact formations. Then also it is important to have sample bags, and you can label your sample with the location and geological coordinates. And to have those coordinates, you need to have a GPS. Now, most of the smartphones are enabled with GPS. GPS reading helps you in pinpointing your location on the map, and you can visit that location again if you have the GPS location. There are certain softwares which can help you in tracing your path during the field work. So it is also an important part of the field work. And also you need to have a map of that particular area. A geological map is always preferred, but if you don't have a geological map, you can at least have a geographical map which can help you in proceeding in correct direction. The next thing is safety in the field. As I mentioned earlier, it is the most important factor in any geological excursion. Be it a student or professional working in the organization, government organization, or in mining or petroleum industry, it is treated as the most important factor. Although you are responsible for your own safety, but the organization or the company for which you are working is also held responsible for any mishap. So if you are not following the safety protocols, you may lose your job. Being a student also, you need to give equal importance to this safety factor. Although the fieldwork or the field study is an enjoyable act, it has inherent risks and hazards. So you may visit coastal exposures, quarries, mines, river sections, mountains, or forests. So depending on the surroundings, you have to take precautions. There are certain cases where the weather conditions are not conducive, and it is important that you carry the first aid kit box always during the fieldwork visit. Then also it is important that you carry food with you, chocolate, biscuit, or anything that can give you energy in instant. So safety, as I told you, is very, very, very important. Next thing is what to look for. Before you visit any field site, you should know what you're expecting. What are the features or sedimentary structures that you may encounter in the field? If you know these things, if you have a certain idea about what you're going to expect, it will be easier for you to make any logical conclusion at the end of the field work. So when you visit the field, you should make observations regarding the lithology. You can find out what is the mineralogy and composition of any particular formation or bed. You have to note down what is the texture of that particular rock, megascopically. It is not always easy to comment in detail about the texture, but still you can find out whether there is any clastic texture or any other kind of texture in that particular sedimentary rock. Also, you have to observe the sedimentary structures carefully. It is very important. The sedimentary structures provide lot of information about the physical parameters of depositional environments. Like for example, if there is any formation or bed showing graded bedding. So graded bedding is an indicative of calm and quiet environment. Or if you find certain cross bedding or certain type of cross bedding. Cross bedding indicates dynamic conditions of deposition. You can find out the paleo current direction. So sedimentary structures and their interpretation is very important. It is also useful in finding the top and bottom of the bedding, whether the fold or any other structure is overturned or normal. Next thing is the color of that particular sedimentary rock, which can also provide information about its composition. Then you have to see what is the geometry or shape of that particular sedimentary body and the relationship between the beds. If there are two beds or within single bed, what is the change in the grain size, in which direction it is increasing or decreasing, what is the change in the scale of sedimentary structures that you have to note down. And finally, fossils. Fossils provide you a lot of information about the age of that particular rock, and the conditions that were existing during the deposition can also be determined by correct observation and identification of fossils. For the list shown previously, the next thing is field notes. You have to make neat and well organized field report, and when you are in the field, you should write down the location, the geographical location of that particular place. What is the nearby town or village, and what is the distance, and what is the name of that road. And also you have to note down the GPS location of that particular location. That will help you in finding more details about that particular spot when you come back from the field. You should also write down in detail about the formation, the name of that particular formation that you're observing, or the section, what is the age. With the help of tape, or approximately you can measure the thickness. You have to write down about the fossils that you're observing and structural features. Now, these field observations noted down in the field diary are very important, and you should be able to correlate your data with your samples when you come back. Also, when you're taking the photograph in the field, that photograph should correlate with the data in your diary. If you're giving any spot number, that spot number should coincide with the image or the number of that image in your camera. So these precautions you need to take during your field observation within the field diary. Then one more important thing you can do in your field diary is you can prepare the graphic logs or litholog as shown here in this diagram. You can see the section in the background, and an overlay of litholog is shown here. I'll tell you how this litholog is prepared. The litholog consists of two axes. In this diagram, on the left hand side at the bottom, you can see x-axis is representing the grain size, starting from the finest on the left hand side. The grain size is increasing, and you can see conglomerate on the extreme right hand side in lithology section. So from left to right, the grain size is increasing. The second column shows the description, and finally the interpretation, and the vertical y-axis is the depth. So when you observe any section in field, by measuring the thickness and by observing the grain size, you can prepare your own litholog in field itself. So when you come back to the classroom, this litholog will be a great tool for visual imagination of that particular section. You can also make this litholog as a part of your field report. Now, in this particular graph, as it is on the left hand side bottom, the grain size is constant, it is not varying with depth. And in field you might get to see certain formations which show upward fining of grain size or upward coarsening of grain size, and that is shown on the top right hand side diagram. You can see the first one on the left hand side is the block diagram where there is no great change in the grain size. The block, you can see it is showing a straight line along that arrow, and it has sharp boundary at the bottom and at the top. Then there is another pattern which is inverted bell shape, where you can see decreasing grain size from top to bottom. As against that, the third one is, let me show you. So here, this is bell shape, this is inverted bell shape, and this is hourglass shape. So this is based on the variation in the grain size. So certain environments have certain characteristic grain size variation. So if you are able to find out this grain size variation in the field, it will help you in identification of the environment there itself. For example, I'll tell you, delta, if you see a cross section of delta, it is something like this. The topmost part is called as delta plain, this one. This is delta front, and this is pro delta. So pro delta consists of fine material which is away from the mouth of the river. The finest sediment can obviously travel longer, therefore fine sediments are seen at the bottom. Then followed by, you'll see sand here in delta front, and coarsest material lies close to the mouth of the river. So if you see a vertical section of a delta, it shows upward coarsening of grain size. If suppose this is y-axis and this is x-axis, the grain size is increasing in this direction. So cross section through a delta will show you a litholog something like this, where you get to see upward increasing grain size. Now this is exactly opposite to a meandering river channel. Now we are not going to go into the details of this, but I just want you to know that you can prepare these lithologs in field based on your observation, and if your observation is correct, it will help you in identification of the environment also. So this is all about the field observations, which is under methodology. Next time we'll discuss about the laboratory experiments or laboratory studies related to the sedimentary petrology.